crowned Miss Mbun. She tells us that Trajet wasn't an easy road to take, but she's there today and she is so happy about it, and it hasn't changed a thing in her life. Stevina Yenu Sangu is our guest, our second guest this morning. Come on in, dear. Oh, the miss. She has to cut walk, you know. Hello, dear. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Oh, my God. You know, just looking at you, I feel like, why didn't I change my career choice? Why didn't I opt for becoming a model, a miss, instead of becoming a journalist? But that's food for thought. We'll talk about that later. Take your seat, dear.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Okay, yeah. And how are you feeling? How is the air of being Miss? What's it like?
I feel very satisfied to have been crowned that day the Miss. Mm-hmm. I also feel very responsible toward that population and the jury that believed on me on that day.
Okay. All right. But apart from the fact that we know you as a fourth-year medical student, who can you say Stevina is? Define your personality.
Je dois vous dire que je suis mon caractère en tant que Stevina Sangon, je dirais que je suis tout d'abord une personne patiente de nature.
Oui.
Je suis patiente, déterminée, sociable, extravertie. Oui. Mais surtout, je dirais que je suis responsable.
Ah, d'accord.
Comme la plupart des filles uniques, je suis parfois un peu capricieuse.
Oui, parce que ça, vous êtes fille unique.
Ouais.
Est-ce que ça vous pose problème d'être fille unique?
Non, bien sûr que non, en toute honnêteté. C'est vrai que parfois, tu te dis, genre, si j'avais une sœur, on aurait telle discussion et tout. Mais j'ai des amis aussi, c'est vrai qu'elles ne remplacent pas. Mais comment avoir le manque de ce qu'on n'a jamais eu?
Ok. Alors, parle-moi un peu de la culture Bamoun.
Oui. Le peuple Bamoun est un peuple qui tient beaucoup, très rattaché à sa culture.
D'accord.
Dans la culture, je parle d'abord du talent de danse traditionnelle. Mm-hmm. Je parle aussi de nos mets qu'on respecte et qu'on chérit tant. Mm-hmm. Je parle aussi de notre vêtu.
Oui.
Généralement, et c'est ce qui est. La femme Bamoun, elle se voit pas son vêtement, pas comment elle s'habille, mm-hmm. pas comment elle est en public.
D'accord.
Donc voilà un peu ça. Et puis notre palais, bien sûr, qui fait un peu notre fierté. Et tout.
Bien sûr, c'est très beau, très joli, vraiment. Et ça, des antiquités, tout ça, qui fait vraiment penser. It makes you think about the ancient times and all of that.
Of course.
But you want to tell us first, what pushed you into, what made you want to compete? I mean, it's not every day we find a medicine student who is into something like this. We know that the scientists are always what we call the bookworms. They are always concentrated on studies and everything. So you want to tell us what pushed you into this?
Yeah. So medical students are very, very occupied by what they do.
Mm-hmm.
But they also tell us and they also teach us that we have to bring ourselves out. Mm-hmm. Let's bring ourselves out of what we
do.
Let's
not socialize.
Exactly.
Okay.
That was the term I was looking for.
Yeah.
Okay. Je me suis présentée au concours d'élection Miss Nguyen pour deux raisons.
D'accord.
Tout d'abord, j'aime la culture en général.
Oui.
J'aime la culture, mais surtout, j'aime ma culture. La culture de mes origines, la culture Bamoun.
D'accord.
Je me suis dit, quoi de mieux que le Nguyen? Mm-hmm. Pour apprendre beaucoup plus de cette culture-là.
D'accord.
Voilà l'une des raisons pour laquelle je me suis présentée à cette compétition.
Mm-hmm.
La deuxième raison, c'est à cause d'une association que je tiens à cœur. Mm-hmm. L'association s'appelle la Jeunesse Médicale du Nord. C'est une association regroupant tous les étudiants en médecine, mm-hmm. originaires du département du Nord, qui œuvrent chaque année dans le but de l'amélioration de l'état de santé de la population du Nord. Sans discrimination.
Okay.
Je suis par ailleurs l'ancienne présidente de cette association et cette année, je me présenterai au poste de la présidente nationale de
bravo.
Cette association.
Okay, so you know that a competition like this is not always easy. How was it during the competition? What are the different difficulties that you faced while competing? Because it was a competition of different stages.
Yeah, that's true. In fact, We had many difficulties. Mm-hmm. I encountered many difficulties.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll first of all start by thanking those that they those that were with us, we had
the organizers.
Yeah.
Okay.
They had everything in place to make us feel comfortable with the competition.
Yeah.
The girls with whom I were competing, although we came there for an aim that was to win the crown.
Yeah.
But we also had that intrinsic value, that's to respect each other. So as the difficulties were less. It's true, I had some difficulties with, to be sincere, I had some difficulties, like the personal dance, that talent, I had to improve on it, I had to work on it because it wasn't
easy. Because you're not a good dancer.
No.
The traditional dance part was one of the toughest for
you. I love my tradition. Yeah. I love our music.
Yeah.
I enjoy dancing our music, but to practice, I wasn't the best.
Right. Okay, so how was this competition structured? Apart from the traditional dance, what were the different stages of the competition?
Les différentes étapes de la compétition sur lesquelles on a été noté étaient d'abord, tout d'abord, nous avons eu la danse, comme je vous ai dit.
Oui.
Nous avons eu un projet qu'il était question qu'on défende en ce jour.
D'accord.
Nous avons aussi eu la présentation en langue vernaculaire.
D'accord.
Nous avons aussi, et c'était aussi sur l'éloquence et bien sûr sur la beauté naturelle de chaque candidate.
D'accord. Donc c'était ça, les étapes différentes de cette compétition.
Exactement.
Alors quand vous a proclamé vainqueur de cette compétition, quand tu as entendu ton nom, quelle émotion as-tu eu en ce moment?
I can't forget that day.
Okay. You want to just describe it a little to us?
Yeah. For those that follow the competition directly, they will see I cried.
Yeah.
I cried. That cry was...
tears of joy.
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. And also, I felt, like I told you, I felt very responsible.
Yeah.
It was a tear of joy, but it was also a tear to remind me that you are here for purpose, you're here for something, you promise us something, you have to bring it out, you have to accomplish that. And I'm very happy, and I hope to always be that best version of me to represent the Fumbanese in the cultural mode everywhere expected.
Of course, we're also hoping that you be the best version of you, but before that, what has changed about you ever since you became Miss Ngun?
I'm a responsible person, I can say that. But it improved my degree of responsibility.
Okay.
It improved me. I feel like I have, like, really, to be honest, less time to waste. My time is to be useful in every aspect, be it social, be it economical, be it intellectual.
Okay.
So that's the first thing I've gained. I've also gained to be a more social person. I'm first of all social in nature, but a more social person.
Yeah.
To be less, like, always put it, no, I'm less, I always put people in front of me.
You're less boring, we can say so.
Yeah.
You socialize more.
Yeah.
You hang out, probably you interact more with people.
Of course.
And all of that.
Of course.
Oh, great.
And I enjoy.
Yeah, but the school that is still on the limelight, right?
I can't forget that.
Okay, so how far have you gone? How are you taking your studies? And how do you juggle, most especially, between being a medicine student, being a miss, and of course your other social life and probably family?
I'm grateful. Yeah. I'm grateful to the president of the committee because she put education first.
Okay.
Recently, I had my evaluation just yesterday. I just finished.
Okay.
She gave me the time needed for me to prepare very well for that.
Okay.
I have things to do, I have certain responsibilities, but school always comes first. With thanks to them, to that, I don't feel the pressure so much.
Yeah.
So that's how I'm able to juggle. I don't juggle by myself, no. I juggle with the help of everyone, the committee.
Okay. All right. Now, besides everything, besides your studious self and of course your responsibilities, do you have other things that you find time to distract yourself with?
Yeah.
Okay. What are those?
I have friends. Normally with friends, but apart from learning, apart from doing what I'm called to be, we sometimes lunch out for dinner together.
Yeah.
We sometimes, like, I love music.
Oh, great.
I love music.
That makes the two of us.
Oh, that's cool. I love music. I love doing karaoke.
Yeah.
So sometimes we hang out doing some karaoke, music and all that. So that's how I pass my time normally.
Okay. Now, so we're slowly but surely terminating this little chit-chat. So I'm going to ask you, looking at all what you've been able to do within a short space of time, what can you tell young girls out there who are watching you and who are aspiring to be like you, to have a career at one hand and to be able to do something else that they love to do at the same time? What's your advice to young girls?
Never to give up.
Okay.
Never to give up. Always believe in their personal value. Mm-hmm. Believe in themselves and believe in their work.
Yeah.
Nothing else, nothing more. And also believe in that man up. He does the best.
Okay. All right. That man up is going to be God. Now, before you go, Stevie, I want you to say something to the Bamun people. Look into the camera, right? And say something to the Bamun people in the vernacular, in your mother tongue.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pawasha, pana, ponta pipimbe o pipumba. Ngupone wunju anga ndi ashina. Mambu mieshe, pomensha, poke lumfenipo. Meaning it's so fresh. I'm fine. We are your lamb to you, Inshallah. Poker Lienge Nippon. Mufaye Reni.
Merci beaucoup, Stevina. C'était Stevina Yengu Sangu, la Miss Ngun 2018. On a été vraiment ravis de t'avoir sur Follow Me et espérons que tu vas revenir quand tu seras docteur.
It'd be a pleasure
for you. Pour nous parler aussi de ça. Mais entre-temps, on va parler d'autres choses. People think that they...